Is there something I can help you with, Mr...
Adley? Edgar Adley? No, I don't think so. Blast Milo and his mad schemes.
Milo?
He was my friend. Came to me a few days ago with a brilliant plan to make some quick galleons. All I had to do was follow him into the Forbidden Forest. Had I known he wanted to procure venom from a living acromantula. Oh, poor Milo. He didn't deserve to go like that.
I'm very sorry to hear about your friend.
Oh, thank you. I can't think of it. Milo's body is still in that cave with the absconder.
The absconder?
Aye, Milo's name for the acromantula. He did have a flair for the dramatic. In fact, as he died, Milo begged me to take his heirloom pocket watch, so that his daughter would have something to remember him by. But I fled.
Why would someone risk their life for spider venom?
As a potion ingredient, acromantula venom is incredibly valuable. In large part because it is, as poor Milo has proven, impossible to get from a live acromantula.
If I have time, I can try to collect the heirloom watch, Mr. Adley.
You can't possibly go to the acromantula's cave. You'd be killed. Please, forget I said anything.
Revelio.
Could you please remind me what you needed help?
My friend Milo and I went to an acromantula's cave, hoping to have it. It didn't go well. Abelius, I'm hoping someone can retrieve an heirloom from Milo.
Revelio. Revelio.
Wonder who lives here.
Revelio.
To see you again.
I've completed my assignments, Professor.
Pleased to hear it. Professor Weasley will be too. I'll be sure to let her know how well you're coming along.
Thank you, Professor.
Professor Hecate tells me she taught you Levioso, so you should be ready for a more advanced levitation charm. Wingardium Leviosa requires a bit of concentration and a nice, graceful wand movement. Let's see you try your hand at it. When executed correctly, you should be able to pick up boulders as though they were sprigs of sneezewort. To practice with pure and natural.
Professor Garlic, a moment of your time?
The plants are resting, so now's as good a time as any.
I was wondering, what made you want to teach herbology?
How lovely of you to ask. I've always had an affinity for greenery, so this situation is a bit of a dream come true. After graduation, I was thrilled to be asked to step in for my old herbology professor. He'd had a slight accident, you see.
Oh dear. A shame for him, but it worked out well for you.
Well, he never cared, really cared for the plants, and they could sense it. Oh, you'd be surprised how perceptive a plant can be. At any rate, the trouble began one day when he cut into a wigan tree. Unfortunately for him, its leaves were hiding a bow truckle. You may recall the marvelous creatures that resemble a twig. The little beast gouged the professor's eyes quite fiercely, but terrifying, I'd imagine. Likely for the professor, too.
And that's when you took over as the herbology professor?
Well, not quite. After 3 weeks at St. Mungo's, my predecessor regained a tiny bit of his eyesight. He insisted on returning to the greenhouse. Within a week, he claims, by accident, kicked a Chinese chomping cabbage, so it was back to St. Mungo's for him.
Fair bit of bad luck there, I'd say.
Well, I felt awful for him, but I dare say I felt a bit more sympathy for the cabbage. Upon his discharge from the hospital, his indifference to plants had turned to utter disdain. He lost what little patience he had left with a particularly temperamental venomous tentacula and, well, his resulting leave of absence continues to this day.
I'm glad everything worked out as it did and that you're the herbology professor now.
Very kind of you to say. I do love these gardens and helping my students grow. Lovely speaking with you. Have a wonderful day. Oh, and remember, be kind to your wigan trees.
Revelio. Wingardium Leviosa. Revelio. Wingardium Leviosa. Revelio. Wingardium Leviosa. Revelio. Wingardium Leviosa. Revelio.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Revelio. Revelio.
What do you have in store for me this time?
Confringo.
What's that? Settled.
Revelio.
thank you enough for all you did to get my carts returned to me. I've been painting and painting. Incredible how such darkness can inspire such beauty. More than happy to purchase that. Good to have stock, I always say. Appreciate you stopping by. Be sure to visit me again, won't you?
Revelio. Revelio.
One of the best meals I've ever eaten.
You're the little sod that saved
me. You're too hot.
Who do you think you are? Help!
I won't let you to fight.
I won't bet. This is impossible.
Once you've completed the necessary tasks, come and find me in the greenhouse.
Revelio. Revelio.
Betting on the dragon fight was the best decision I've made yet.
Revelio.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Shame you're so foul.
Revelio.
Dangerous if I'm not careful.
Revelio. Incendio! Revelio! Revelio. Revelio.
Is simply too many. Rebellion.
Expelliarmus. Confringo. Incendio. Incendio. Incendio.
Wingardium Leviosa.
Incendio.
This Revelio. Revelio.
Revelio. Revelio.
smile and try when I see one.
Wingardium Leviosa.
Revelio.
Wingardium Leviosa. Wingardium Leviosa.
Revelio. Revelio.
Seems a pleasant enough little place.
Revelio.
Wingardium Leviosa. Thank you.
best of me. Revelio. It. Revelio. 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 Accio. Incendio. Revelio.
On Earth, we deport a plan to defeat our enemies. I put forth a fine approach of how we should proceed, and it's simply ludicrous that I think.
No! Confringo!
No.
Revelio.
I know, I'm not hearing things.
Revelio.
Can't do that!
I don't like the looks.
Revelio.
Ha! You're easier to spot than an illegal nobby.
I quit now while you're still alive.
You can't hold out forever.
Incendio. Accio. Rebellion.
Revelio.
They don't seem to care for me. Can't say I blame them, what with all I've done there.
You'll soon bear the scars of my wrath.
Expelliarmus. Confringo. Accio. Incendio.
Can't pick Confringo. A fire, you know. Might want to look up.
Barely felt anything at all.
What are your thoughts on
electric? Expelliarmus.
Now where did it go?
Confringo. Incendio.
Body buying curse on all of my colleagues. I know a body.
Trouble's brewing and I'm without my friends.
Expulso! That's the best.
Accio.
defending themselves.
Revelio.
An Ashwinder, no less. Perhaps not the best place to be caught alone.
Thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Have you finished your assignments?
Reporting back, Professor. Assignments all finished.
Well done. Shows good discipline. Wisdom is a golden snitch, as they say. And you're proving a skilled seeker in that regard. Let us practice our restore momentum. A charm, incidentally, created to stop Quaffles from plummeting straight to the ground during a Quidditch match. Precise, deliberate movements. Very good.
Arrest them.
That's it. Keep it up.
Professor, do you have a moment?
Yes, what is it?
In class, I heard you mention the Toyohashi Quidditch team.
I did. The Toyohashi Tengu are from Japan. Dominant, known for their rigorous training. They practice near the Mahutokoro School of Magic, often battling both tempestuous seas and violent storms, in addition to each other. Tournament play is almost always easier for the Tengu than their training sessions.
I take it you're a fan.
Fan? I was being groomed to play on their team. And I would have been a Tengu, if not for a bit of bad luck.
If you were that good, I can't believe a bit of bad luck could end your entire Quidditch career.
I was excellent. My ability on a broom had nothing to do with what happened. I was betrayed by someone I trusted. Myself. I did not see clearly and I paid a dear price. My best friend Asuka and I were being groomed to play on the team together. I as keeper and she as chaser. She was breathtaking. She once corkscrewed through three players and scored before they even turned their heads. But as tryouts for the Tengu got closer, she panicked. I did not realize the extent of her panic until it was too late. She wanted so desperately for both of us to play together that she had slipped Felix Felicis into our tea before we were to show them our skills.
Liquid luck? That's illegal, isn't it?
It is indeed. I knew within minutes that something was different. I had never played so well. And Asuka was playing more beautifully than I had ever seen. When I confronted her afterwards, she admitted what she had done. I withdrew from consideration immediately.
But it wasn't your fault. You didn't know about the potion in the tea.
It does not matter. My flying that day was not my own. I could not live with myself. So, I withdrew and explained to them why. I burned my broom in disgrace.
What happened to Asuka? Did she burn her broom as well?
Asuka played for the Tengu for 2 seasons.
You didn't report her? Tell them what she'd done?
Her fate was not mine to decide. My fate is in my hands, as your fate is in yours.
Thank you, Professor. I shall remember what you've told me.
A Arresto Momentum.
Well done. You are on your way to mastering Arresto Momentum.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Perhaps a hybrid. Bouncing.
Revelio.
Spectacular.
I've finished the activities you assigned me, Professor Garlic.
Wonderful! I hope you gained a greater appreciation for the flora in our lives. I am forever enraptured by it. Just yesterday, I spent hours pruning my self-fertilizing shrubs and flutterby bushes. Didn't realize how long I'd been at it until the sun began to set. Well, if there's one thing I love to see more than my plants thriving, it's one of my students doing the same. Now, ready to learn flipendo? Chin up, keep a light grip, and it's all in the wrist. Let's see you give it a go. You will want to focus with this spell. Nothing as mortifying as knocking back a colleague when all you wanted to do was move a few pots. Wonderfully done! If you'd like to practice a bit more, you're welcome to do so here in the greenhouse. Just mind the plants, please. Suggest you practice such maneuvers in a more secluded location. Now, where was I? Oh, yes.
Professor, I was wondering where you're from. What's your background?
Oh, how nice of you to ask. Well, let's see, I grew up in London, right on the Thames.
That sounds lovely. All the sights and bustle of a city.
To some, yes. I used to dream of living in the country, but it wasn't until I came to Hogwarts that I felt truly at home. Mind you, it did take some time, and whilst it is my fervent hope that each student eventually feels as at home here as I do, it is not always the case.
I suppose that makes sense.
Well, we each bloom differently, don't we? Some of us, like Devil's Snare, thrive in the shadows, whilst others crave the attention of a bouncing bulb. And we each grow and thrive according to our own plan. Oh, I was terribly nervous when I arrived at the castle. You see, as a child, I knew nothing of witches or wizards. You can imagine how astonished I was to receive my letter from Hogwarts. I spent a good deal of time alone in either the greenhouse or the library my first days here.
It does take a while to adjust to being here.
Precisely, and I was remarkably fortunate. In fact, a seventh year took me under her wing during those first days. She remains one of my dearest friends.
How fortunate.
I was indeed. I dare say you'll find that the friends you make here at Hogwarts will last a lifetime. Now, I'd best get to my recent delivery from the Magic Neep. Mr. Teasdale promised me quite an assortment of seeds this week. Lovely to see you.
Revelio. Please could you remind me the purpose of it?
Of course, dear. Professor Weasley has kindly asked that I give you some tasks. Once you've completed them all, be sure to...
Welcome. Do let me know if I can be of any assistance at all.